How's it going, everybody? Welcome back to the channel. This is your boy Mars. Today is a special day that I'm super excited to show you guys the Camaro Pro Stock in the background. Oh man, this thing is fast. Finally, there's a car that's faster than everything out there in the drag strip. I know top end speed, I think the Jesco is still the top, is the highest top speed vehicle still. But this is the quickest, 100%. This is the quickest car out there. I am just going to show you guys everything from the build to the tune to how to drive it, launch it, all that good stuff, man. This thing is super fast. I'm giving you guys a hell of a fast tune. So I hope you guys enjoy it. Subscribe if you guys are new to the channel. And yeah, let's get right to it. So as you guys see in the background, we got the 2013 Chevy Summit Racing Pro Stock Camaro. Let's go right over here to the upgrades, custom upgrades. So the car is an original build vehicle that normally comes naturally aspirated with a big block engine, and that is 1400 horsepower. But when putting it into Forza, you're able to up that horsepower. So as you guys see, you can choose either the twin turbos or the supercharger. I went twin turbos to get a higher top end speed. Also is lower in the weight, so twin turbo is the best way to go. Put those twin turbos in there. You are able to make it all-wheel drive. All-wheel drive, do not go all-wheel drive. Please do not. This thing grips like a monster, and it just drives really, really, really good. So do not go all-wheel drive at all, okay? And that is it with that. Let's go right over here to the build. All you can do is put the anti-lag on the turbos there and also put this intercooler there to get 1800 horsepower with 1,000 foot-pounds of torque, weighing only 2400 pounds. Insane stats. Let's go right over here. Gonna leave that alone because we're gonna mainly use a lot of the gears, pretty much all the gears. And then coming over here, we're gonna put this rally just so that we can just adjust the gears a lot easier for that differential. But that is it. That is it right over here with the tires. You leave this alone. They already are drag tires, so you don't need to do anything with that. And apparently these wheels are not the lightest weight wheels, so make sure to put lighter wheels on the car. So I got these wheels on here, super light. And that is it. The size of the wheels, please leave it alone at the 15 and 16s in the rear. Do not make it bigger or anything like that. That might be a little bit of an experiment for later on for me, maybe doing the rear a little bit bigger to kind of get a stronger grip or something like that. But so far I have it running really, really well. It's more of a consistent run for everybody to have. Of course, the longer you guys keep tweaking the car, I believe you can get a little bit faster. And remember, this is a tune that I did in about an hour or so. So I haven't spent like days on it to kind of, you know, fix it as much as I can and get as fast as I can. But this is, the numbers you're going to see are, you know, fairly quick. So that is that. With that, let's go right to the tune, guys. I'll show you guys everything. The car says it does a 0.80 to 60, 1.50 to 100, traps around 286, 55 tire pressure in the front, 15 in the rear. Here goes the final drive at 385. First gear is all the way to 6, so super short gear, and it still grips. Then second gear is 275, 180, 129, and 0.93. So these are my numbers. Hopefully you guys can make it faster if you guys can. If you guys can't, well, you got a hell of a fast tune. So let's go right over here. Everything is zeroed out in 7, 65, 65. Springs all the way low and the vehicle all the way to the ground. So initially, some of the cars, you know how they wheelie and stuff like that. You don't want that for real drag racing cars. It's just too much. You lose momentum, a lot of momentum wheeling. With these cars, it's just kind of, you want it to stick and go, stick and go. It's like, it's crazy. So, and then we got with the dampening at 991 and 1. Nothing with this, nothing with this. Leave that alone. I think it's 80 already. And then 100 and 100. So that is it with this monster of a vehicle. 1,800 horsepower. Super excited. I honestly was a little bit upset that they only gave us one. But I can tell Forza are going to see how much the community really loves this Pro Stock vehicle. And it is the fastest thing out there. The quickest, I want to say. We're here to the house. Let's take it out for a little spin. Let's take a look at the inside of this crazy cockpit. Looking insane. Oh my gosh, it sounds insane. So as you guys see, looking crazy. This is one of my paint jobs that I normally do on like my crazy fast cars. I call it the shark paint job, but the two-tone paint job is like a matte paint job. It just looks great. I knew it was going to look great on this vehicle, so I decided on going with it. And besides that, here goes my stats. Make sure to be everything the way I have it. Standard steering wheel is the best way to go. If you guys are tending to drive my cars and for some reason they spin or they don't grip, this is a main reason why. Make sure to leave it on standard. Do not leave it on simulation. Make sure to go standard. Manual with clutch is the way to go. We're not using a launch control or anything of that nature. So this tune here is an all-around tune. You can bring it out to the drag strip event or bring it out to the drag strips. The over there we're going to go to right now. And you can just, run whoever you want with the three horn honks or whatever. So it's an all-around vehicle. It's running really, really well. So let's just go. Take it out for a nice spin. Insane of a car. As you guys see, there is absolutely no turn radius with it. It's just a straight line vehicle. Great vehicle just to bring out and have some fun with. The only competitor for this car is itself. There is nothing out there that really can keep up with it. You guys are going to see right now in the half a mile, in the quarter mile times, it's just ridiculous amount of numbers that are crazy high. And the car, all the way around, it doesn't feel that it's going fast, but it really, really is going fast. Like, I guess because of the camera angle, you're not really like inside of the vehicle. But as you guys see, look at that. I just did a 284 right there, top end speed. Remember, this only designed for the quarter mile. If you guys bring it on the highway, as you guys see, I think it's already capped at like a 286 or so. So there's nothing really you can do. So real simple, no burnouts, no nothing, guys. This car already massively hooks really well. So what you're going to do is just 2K launch it here out in the street. All that means is you're going to stop right here. Just press brake and gas. It's going to do this. Hold right there. We got 8 pounds of boost torque. It's 1,000 foot-pounds of torque. All you got to do is let go of the e-brake, and that's it. So all of the gears are very smooth. As you guys see, my gears are all back to back to back. The only one that's the longest is that fifth gear, because the half a mile ends like all the way at the end over there. So all in all, see those trap numbers, that is insane. I'm gonna bring it out right now to the drag strip, and then I'm gonna show you guys how to drive it on the drag strip. It's all gonna be about sound. So as soon as you guys launch, you guys are gonna hear the car about a red line, and you're gonna shift to the second gear. Do not let a red line, if not, the car is not going to drive well. So let's see what we did. So right there, you guys saw that trap speed. Let's do it one more time. A lot of people trying to get this vehicle. You guys actually can get the vehicle from what AR said. Pretty much I got this from sniping it. But if you guys go here, you guys have to do every single one of these events, even all these down here, or all the ones that are able to be unlocked. And you were able to get that 80 points there that you need to get the Camaro. So you are able to get it. It's going to take a while, or if you can find it in the storefront, if somebody puts it out there. Make sure for the storefront, you are not playing multiplayer. You're trying to play at your highest speed you can for your internet, and then just trying to get it as quickly as you can. That's the only way that I can, my strongest suggestion. So another launch real quick, e-brake gas. And then we're going to let go of the e-brake. And there we go. Throw back-to-back gears. But look at this trap speed in this half a mile here, which is a little longer than a half a mile. But look at that. 262 miles per hour. No vehicle is tapping that right there. No vehicle, unless you are going way further back, or if you guys are hacking the game or something. Besides that, there isn't none of the vehicles are doing that from where I was at, from that standstill. And then let's go to the quarter mile here real quick. Let's do the street quarter mile, which is this pole right over here. Same exact launch, best launch we got here with the car. I probably might do like my own tune, which is probably gonna be like one of these up here high. But it's doing fairly well because remember, this is an all around tune. You guys can just bring it out. We're gonna go right now after this 2 quarter mile strip, the event. And you guys can see. So we're lined up. Let go of that e-brake. Look at that. It just hooks and books. No wheelie, no nothing. And boom, a 225 and a quarter mile. Holy crap. Time. That is insane. All right, let's go and then do the events real quick. AR12 here. So this is the quarter mile. This is his quarter mile. Let's go right in here. We're going to do his quarter mile real quick. So you guys can see what it does in a quarter mile. The car is not tuned for the quarter mile, but it still does a consistent number, which is a lot lower than what he was doing in his video. But I mean, you know, it's just going to take a little bit of time to even get to somebody actually break world records like this. So all it is about sound, guys. Manual with clutch is the way to go. As you guys see, the gears come very, very quickly. So as soon as you hear it, there you go. I did a 6.3 in the quarter mile. But yeah, all I'm doing is pressing the gas all the way down, guys. And as soon as it says go, I hear the engine. The car moves like a couple feet forward. And then I shift to the second gear, third gear, fourth gear, manual with clutch. And then that's how you get those numbers. I think I did all 4 gears. There are, I think it's 4, 3, 4. So that is it with that. And then I'm going to show you guys the, it'll keep doing consistent 6.3s consistently. So can't go wrong with that at all. Let's do the half a mile now. Look at this turn radius. Chevys normally don't even turn that good as well in the first place. So let's go here real quick. And now let's do half a mile. What the heck? Feels like cars that really not supposed to be. But I hope this leaderboard gets fixed. But besides that, the leaderboard is going to be what it's going to be. So, for a shot. There you go. So, as you see, look at that leaderboard. It's already all messed up. I'm already in, like, where the leaderboard is messed up at. There we go. So, let's see what we did here. Boom. At an 11.085, guys. 11.085. Insane. That was just on my first pass. That's not me doing like multiple passes or anything like that. That's how I want my tunes for all you guys. You guys can always have a really fast car just from the hit. You know, you guys don't have to like use it as many times. So listen to the sound and listen to the shift. Boom. So it just, that's how it goes. So it's gonna be pretty much just like that. As soon as you move forward, you're gonna shift to that second gear. Try not to do it so early or too late. Too late, you're gonna bounce off that gear. And it's gonna suck, and too early, of course, you're gonna kind of bog. So right there, I did a higher number, but yeah, I think my fastest was a 0.06. I think that was my fastest. So I think I'll, you guys are probably gonna see any other video or not. But look at the way that the hack is, the way he launched on that. It's like so fake. Then the car just slows down towards the end. But yeah. There we go, consistent vehicle, beautiful vehicle. I'm so happy they gave us something like this. Doing consistent 7-0s, man. Consistency is insane. And I really hope you guys like my video. Hope you guys subscribe if you guys are new. And yeah, man, that sums up the video. See you guys around with another drag tune video. Peace out, everybody. Bye-bye now.